What's up, YouTube? This your boy, B-Boy Facts, Johnny TV, and tonight I'm going to give you guys my WWE SmackDown review on how I see you guys new. Hit that like button, it helps YouTube out of rhythm. Also, go subscribe to my channel, tap that notification bell every time I premiere a brand new video. Follow my social media, my Twitter, my Instagram, my TikTok, and Twitch down below in the description, and let's get started. Now, SmackDown was a solid show. It was just solid. Alright, we're kicking things off with in-ring segment. In-ring segment, Edge. Edge takes a seat in the ring. Edge says this thing with Seth Rollins all started 7 years ago. Rollins tries to use Edge as a stepping stone. Rollins knows Edge wasn't medically cleared to compete, but Edge came to SmackDown to answer Rollins' challenge. But Rollins went to Edge's home, not his house, his home. There was a big difference. Rollins is watching from backstage. Edge underestimate Rollins. Edge says Rollins is the only person who comes close to matching his passion. Rollins ain't there yet. Rollins isn't Edge. Like, Edge was wrong. He says freaking Rollins. Rollins is his own man. Because of that, he has the end of this. Edge could go to Rollins' house, or he could have a chance to encounter with Becky Lynch. But where would it end? Edge has had his moment of doubt. He won't hesitate to put Rollins down. At Hell in a Cell, Edge is going to scare Rollins so that's not a scare you ever heal from. Alright, so we get the King of the Ring, round two. Finn Balor versus Sami Zayn. This was a decent match. Decent. Balor takes Sami Zayn down and slaps on a hammerlock. Balor sends Sami Zayn out of the ring. Balor lands a dive. After the break, Balor hits a pelly kick. Sami Zayn goes up top. Balor cuts him off. Sami Zayn headbutts Balor off the top. Sami Zayn leaps off the top rope into a dropkick from Balor. Sami Zayn kicks out. Sami Zayn surprises Finn Balor with a blue thunder bomb. Finn Balor kicks out. Sami Zayn suplexes Balor into the corner. Sami Zayn missed a hell of a kick. Sami Zayn rolls up Balor with his feet on the ropes. The referee catches it. Sami Zayn argues with the referee. Balor lands two drop kicks. Balor lands his painted double stomp off the top for the win. The winner of the match, Finn Balor. This was a decent match. Alright, so we get Naomi versus Sonya Deville. As Naomi makes her way to the ring, Deville is shown watching backstage. After the break, Sonya Deville walks out on the stage and says it's going to be Naomi versus Sonya Deville and Shayna Baszler. So we got a handicap match. Naomi versus Sonya Deville and Shayna Baszler. I didn't pay attention to this match. But I can say it is though, Naomi deserves better. Deville tells the referee that they will all be in the ring at the same time. Deville slaps Naomi. Naomi chases Deville. Shayna Baszler tries to grab Naomi, but Naomi kicks her in the head. Naomi clocks Baszler, Shayna Baszler. Sonya Deville surprised Naomi with a running knee. Baszler holds Naomi while Deville works her over. Naomi blasts Deville in the face. Naomi catches Baszler with a disaster kick. Naomi sets up for a split-legged moonsault. Deville hooks Naomi's leg. Baszler puts Naomi in a kafuta clutch. Naomi passes out. Deville pins her with her foot on her chest. The winners of the match, Sonya Deville and Shayna Baszler. They didn't really care about this handicap match. Backstage, Sasha Banks says she is going to right something wrong. She started with Bianca Belair last week and this week Becky Lynch. The boss is going to be the new SmackDown Women's Champion. So we get the in-ring segment, Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins says Edge tries to convince himself and everyone here that he has a chance at Crown Jewel. Rollins says he isn't afraid or intimidated to face Edge in Hell in a Cell. Rollins says he is better than Edge on every level. He has a mental and physical advantage against Edge. Rollins retaliates that he isn't afraid of Edge in Hell in a Cell. Alright. Rollins yells that he spent more time in the cell than Edge has. Alright, let's move on. It says backstage, Selena Vega and Carmella agreed to have a nice fair match. Vega promised not to try to break Carmella's face, so she doesn't need her protective mask. The Queen of the Ring, round two, Selena Vega versus Carmella. This was a quick match. Carmella tells her helpers they can't leave because she doesn't need her mask. Carmella rolls up Vega. Vega kicks out. Vega rolls up Carmella. Carmella kicks out. Carmella locks Vega in the armbar. Vega used the ropes to flip out of the hole. Vega hip toss Carmella. Carmella kicks Vega in the face. Vega is lived. Carmella says it was out of habit. Carmella says she's sorry. Vega tackles Carmella and lands a series of punches to the face. Carmella crawls away and yells for her helpers to give her the mask. Liv Morgan is standing outside the ring, holding the mask. Morgan flinches at Carmella. Carmella rolls back into the ring. Vega rolls Carmella up with a small package for the win. The winner of the match, Selena Vega. Alright, let's move on. Happy talk. This segment, I don't really care. Corbin and Madcap do stuff. Thankfully, we are rescued by Shinsuke Nakamura and Rick Boogs, who just dance around the ring. The Street Profits music cuts and Boogs plays that on his guitar. The Street Profits dance with Shinsuke Nakamura on the stage. So we get the SmackDown Tag Team Championship Street Fight. The Usos versus the Street Profits. This was pretty good. Ford and Dawkins are all over Jimmy and Jay as soon as the bell rings. Dawkins hits his net breaker, but Jay rolls out of the ring. Ford traps Jimmy in the corner. Jay grabs Ford and hits a back suplex into a neck breaker for a near fall. Jimmy and Jay beat down Dawkins outside the ring. Ford dives over the ring post and lands on Jimmy and Jay. Dawkins tells Ford to get the tables before the Street Profits are setting up. Jimmy and Jay land stereo dives. After the break, Jimmy and Jay wear Dawkins out candlesticks. Ford surprised them with a crossbody off the top. Ford tosses a chair at Jay. Jay catches it. Ford kicks the chair in Jay's face. Alright, Jimmy hits a pop-up Samoan drop on Ford. Dawkins and Ford land a combo suplex on Jay. Dawkins and Ford work Jimmy over with a chair and a candlestick. The Street Profits set up a doomsday device. Jay saves Jimmy. The Usos drop Ford and Dawkins with a super kick. Dawkins and Ford both kick out. Ford and Dawkins hit their finish. Ford tries to pin Jimmy, but Jay pins Ford out of the ring. Jay slams Ford through a table. Dawkins eats a series of super kicks. Both Usos land splash on Dawkins and Jay. On Dawkins, Jay pins Dawkins. The winner is still your SmackDown Tag Team Champions, the Usos. This was a pretty good match. Alright, let's move on. So we get Sasha Banks versus Becky Lynch. This was a good match. Belair is out for commentary. Becky Lynch and Banks trade pin attempts. Neither woman can keep the other from a three count. Lynch almost applies to disarm her. Banks almost turns it into the bank statement. Becky Lynch escapes. Sasha Banks lands a double knee strike in the corner. Becky Lynch catches Banks with a running bulldog. Sasha Banks kicks out. It says Becky Lynch catches Sasha Banks with a running bulldog. Banks kicks out. Banks fires up and lands a Three Amigos. Becky Lynch kicks out. Becky Lynch sends Sasha Banks into the ring post. Becky Lynch puts Sasha Banks in the disarmbar, rising the rope. Sasha Banks is hung up in the ropes. Becky Lynch lands a leg drop for a near fall. Becky Lynch works over Banks. Banks managed to pull Becky Lynch into the ring post. Sasha Banks matches Lynch with a meteor into the ring post. Sasha Banks lands another off the top. Becky Lynch kicks out. Sasha Banks hits a backstabber. Becky Lynch managed to roll out of the ring to avoid getting pinned. Sasha Banks tries to sunset flip bomb, but Becky Lynch turns into a leg drop on apron. Becky Lynch dives off the top into the bank statement. Becky Lynch traps, but they are outside of the ring. Sasha Banks sends Becky Lynch back in the ring. Frog splash by Sasha Banks. Becky Lynch kick out. Sasha Banks lands a double knee in the corner. Sasha Banks tries it again, but Becky Lynch turns it into a back exploder into the corner. Irish jam off the top by Becky. Sasha Banks kicks out. Becky Lynch accidentally clock Bellew outside the ring. Sasha Banks leaps off the commentary desk and knees Becky Lynch in the face. Becky Lynch crashes into the barricade. Both women end up back in the ring. Becky Lynch tries Sasha Banks in the armbar. Sasha Banks turns it into a pin. Becky Lynch kicks out. Becky Lynch tries the manhandle slam. Sasha Banks turns it into a pin. Becky Lynch kicks out. Belair tries to whip Becky Lynch with her hair, but Becky Lynch avoids it in the confusion. Sasha Banks hits the backstabber for the win. The winner of the match, Sasha Banks. This match was good, and the ending was awesome. That's all I got to say. So we get the contract signing. Brock Lesnar sits down and puts his feet up on the table and the ring. Roman Reigns just stares dagger at Lesnar. Lesnar smoothly doesn't have a care in the world. Roman Reigns tells Heyman to review the contract. Paul Heyman tells Reigns the contract has everything he asks for in his counsel. Is to sign the contract. Roman Reigns doesn't even look at the contract. He just signs it and tosses it on the table. Roman Reigns laughs and calls Lesnar a you know what for not reading the contract before signing it. Lesnar laughs and says he read the contract this morning with his advice, Paul Heyman. Roman Reigns face drop. Brock Lesnar laughs as he leaves the ring. Paul Heyman clutches the Universal Championship at Sphere, and SmackDown goes off the air. But like I stated earlier, SmackDown was a solid show, and that's all I got to say from there. But anyway, if you guys enjoyed my WWE SmackDown review on highlights, please drop a like on this video. It helps YouTube algorithm. Subscribe to my channel. Tap the notification bell every time I premiere a brand new video. Also, follow my social media, my Twitter, my Instagram, and TikTok, and Twitch down below in the description. And that's all I got said from there. But I want to give a shout out to my friend ECW Gamer for giving me a raid on Twitch last night. And also I want to give a shout out to my friend Ice Dragon. He came to my stream. Arcade came to my Twitch stream last night. That was very awesome for them three. Anyway, this your boy, B-Boy Facts Johnny, and I'll see you guys in my AEW Rampage review on highlights. I'll talk to you guys later. This your boy, B-Boy Facts Johnny TV, and I'm out of here. Peace out, guys.